Okay, now let us look at the profit and loss account. So as we said, profit and loss account is a financial statement. It's a financial statement prepared at the end of the accounting period. To determine the net profit or loss obtained in that period. So it's prepared to determine the net profit or loss. So you can suffer a loss or you can get a profit. So how do we get the net profit? From the previous financial statement, that's a trading account, we determine the gross profit. So from the trading account, we continue to the profit and loss account. So after getting the gross profit, you add the trading revenues. Then you less all the trading expenses. After raising all the trading expenses, the resulting figure is the net profit. So we can say net profit equals to gross profit add trading revenues, then you less trading expenses. So I'm using the word trading meaning you only deal with the expenses or revenues which affect the business, which affects only the business, not the person or the proprietor. So we knew how to get the gross profit. Now can we look at the examples of the trading revenues? Examples of trading revenues, we have the discount received. Discount received. We have commission received. And we have rent received. A revenue is income. Any income which you get from other activities other than the main business activities. So if you buy goods, you are given an allowance. That is the discount. That allowance will increase your income in the business. Also, you can do some other businesses apart from the main business, then you receive a commission. That commission will increase your income. For example, you have some rooms which you are receiving, you are a landlord, you are receiving rent. That rent you can use it in the business, so it will increase your income. That's why we are adding them. They will increase your gross profit. Then we look at the examples of trading expenses. Because we say the discount received is now a revenue, discount allowed is an expense. Discount allowed is an expense. Commission allowed is an expense. Rent paid or rent due We have the cartilage outwards. Now, cartilage outwards, these are the transportation cost of the goods which have been sold to the customers. You sell the goods and then you transport the goods to the customer's premises. We call them cartilage outwards. These are expenses to the business. So it will reduce your revenue. We have rent, I've said. We have the salaries and wages. We have rates. We have transport. All can call it traveling. Traveling expenses. Stationery. And printing. We have water and electricity. There are so many, etc. Any cost which we incur when you are carrying out the business activities, we call them trading expenses. Because you have known now the trading revenues and trading expenses, now let us use the question. Now the owner of the business is Mukuza Traders. Profit and loss account is the name of the statement. For the year ended at 1st December 2018, that's the date. So as we said, we use the vertical format. So according to our question, we can just use the figures which we are given. We are given the gross profit. So we start with the gross profit. We write in the last column. Let me see whether we have our revenue. Okay, gross profit. We write the last column. 78,870. Then we say add revenues. Revenues we are given, discount received. Revenues, now we write them in the second column to get the totals. Okay, we are given only one revenue, so the total will be the same. 12,200. We just add. Now we are getting 81,070. This is the total income. Total income. Then now we less trading expenses. Trading expenses, we are given 3 of them. We have discount allowed. If we have any adjustment for the expenses, we adjust them in the first column. If we have an adjustment. But now here, in our question, we don't have any adjustment. We just write the second column, 4,000. Then we have carriage outwards. $500. We have rent paid. Rent paid, 40,000. Let's get the total. So the total is 44,500. Because we said less trading expenses, now we use a bracket. A bracket means we are deducting. So now we are deducting 91,070 and 44,500. You can use your calculator, but I can deduct it. So 44,500. So the total would be 46,570. Now this figure is what we call net profit. Now this is the net profit. Okay, you can serve a loss. I said you can get a loss or you get a profit. So in our case, the trading expenses are less than the total income. So we have got the net profit. But in case the total trading expenses are more than the total income, then you suffer a loss. It will be a net loss. If total expenses are more than total income, then the resulting figure is net loss. So whenever you get a loss, you are right. Don't say you are wrong in your calculations. So that is the end of the profit and loss account. So it is better to look for the past papers. You do them for you to know whether you have understood.